Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create the look of vintage lomographs from normal photos. Lomographs typically have high contrast and unusual saturation and color. This look is the result of a technique in photographic processing in which film that's intended for slide chemistry is processed in photographic negative chemistry, and vice versa. Open a photo you'd like to use for this project. I downloaded this one from Shutterstock. Before we begin, you should know that some of the filters used in this tutorial were first introduced in version CS6. There are workarounds for earlier versions of Photoshop. However, to save time, I won't be going over them in this video. To ensure that the settings will be applied correctly to your image, check its resolution by going to Image and Image Size. Make its resolution 150 pixels per inch. We'll convert our image into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively as well as adjust the effects that we'll be adding to it. Click the icon at the upper right of the Layers panel and click Convert to Smart Object. Go to Filter and Lens Correction. Click the Custom tab and drag the vignette slider all the way to the left. Then click OK. Go back to Filter, Blur Gallery, and Iris Blur. To adjust the size of the blur, place your cursor on the ring and drag the ring out almost to the edges of your image. To adjust the amount of blur, drag the blur slider or type in an amount. I'll type in 5 pixels. Keep in mind, since every photo has its own unique characteristics, you may want to adjust the setting amounts throughout this video to tailor it to your photo. To accept the iris blur, click OK at the top. Go back to Filter, Sharpen, and Unsharp Mask. Make the amount 80%, the radius 2 pixels, and the threshold 0 levels. Then click OK. This adds contrast to all the edges. Click the Adjustment Layer icon and click Color Lookup. Open the Load 3D LUT flyout list and click Film Stock 50.3DL. Click the Adjustment Layer icon again, and this time click Photo Filter. I'll click Cooling Filter 82, however, feel free to try different filters. Next, we'll add a few light leaks. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. Change its blend mode to Linear Dodge. Open your Brush Tool and Brush Picker. We'll take care of the size in a moment. Make its hardness 0% and its opacity 40%. Click the foreground color and pick a bright red. Then click OK. To make your brush bigger or smaller, press the right or left bracket key on your keyboard. I'll make its size 600 pixels. Click once or twice on areas of your image. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.